being here, taking the time to come inside on such a unseasonably nice day. You know, I can usually count on this being like no one wanting to really be anywhere else on this day with the weather, but here we are. So you just heard the concert playing band play Storm Chasers. We're now going to tackle a piece called Alligator Alley. I have looked at this one in our library for the last 10 years being like, man, I want to try this. This looks hard and fun, but I haven't had the right concert band yet to do it until this year. Part of the reason, and you'll hear it, is we have two wonderful bassoon players, and there's like, yeah, woo, that's right. And this piece has a lot of exposed moments for them, so you'll get to hear them all by themselves, no pressure test. All right, on this piece, here's Alligator Alley.
Thank you. Thank you.
but this next piece is a little weird, so I've given you a forewarning. And when I first programmed this, I'm like, oh, when I saw the title, I was like, cool, it's the first steam turbine ship, right? How cool is that? This is like prototype, this is the first one ever built in the spawnest generation of, you know, of seafaring vessels and all that kind of stuff. And then I listened to the music, it's like super dark, right? But then I found out that this boat was in a wreck. It was almost split entirely in two by this other ship. So it made sense to me. And you'll hear, like, it's really sort of inspired, like, the way the composer has, like, knitted these little motifs together, sort of like gears and cogs and engine. So really well done. The composer is a Gustavus graduate, and she resides in Minnesota. Her name is Catherine Bergman. So here we go with Turbinia. Next piece is hard, and it's hard because it's slow and sometimes quiet, and it takes a lot of maturity. lot of maturity to focus, right, on delivering something that is really sort of an intimate reflection song, right? Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. This piece, it starts with like a really straightforward statement of it, and then Frank Kelly, he breaks it down into little bits and slowly builds it until it like is really big, and then brings it back down. So here's Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
point for our last one, we're gonna do something I've never done at a concert band concert. It's like programs, video game music, right? It's epic, right? So here, this is 12-8 groove throughout. Fun fact, this is from the video game Civilization VI, which I have not played due to my demanding workload here at school. I thought that maybe I would find time for it before this concert, so I have more context to give you. But alas, here I am, video game-less. Right? But I did find out that this game has grossed at least $500 million. Right? They don't publish the exact numbers from the company, but people are guessing. $500 million for one video game. Right? And this is the sixth one. Right? So this is where where our entertainment is for a large portion, and it's a new sort of like frontier for classical music, video game music composing, because they have these huge budgets and they can bring in the 100-piece orchestra to record everything. So here's Christopher Tin's Sogno di Volare.
Thank you. Thursday morning, the wind ensemble is going to perform at the South Suburban Conference Band Festival, which is held at Shakopee High School. And parents, I need your help because we have to be here at school at 6:30 a.m. on Thursday morning. We're ready to go because we're scheduled in the very first session and to perform. And I know it's kind of a bummer that we're in that first session, but we've dodged that bullet for so many years. It was our turn to take one for the team. So 6:30. Anyway, the piece that we're playing, first of all, tonight, and the piece that we're playing at the end of the concert are the two pieces that we're going to play at the South Suburban Band Festival. And the first piece that we're going to play is a piece that I heard about 25 years ago, and I thought, ah, oh, it's a great piece. And there were a couple of band arrangements out there, and they were good, but nothing that really fit or worked for this year's wind ensemble. So this past summer, I had some friends of mine who fly me down to Austin, Texas, to dog sit for them. I know, it's a rough gig, rough gig. Anyhow, when I was in Austin, there was like this amazing, incredible heat wave the whole time that I was there. So you didn't want to go outside anytime between 9 a.m. and 10 p.m. So basically, I was stuck inside the house with the two dogs the whole time. And so what I did is from sunup to sundown is I arranged this next piece that the wind ensemble is going to play and just wrote it all out and got it set to go, and I think it fits this group really well. I hope you enjoy this. This is Camille Saint-Saëns' finale from the Organ Symphony, number 3 in C major.
Thank you. Thank you.
ensemble did a concert during the day for the elementary school fourth graders on this side of the district. They're in the process of signing up for band, and we call it a demonstration concert where we try to feature each of the instruments, and we have a student or two from each section get up and talk about their instrument and why they chose that instrument and a little bit about the instrument. So I picked pieces that we played at that concert. They were a little more lighthearted than the last piece that we just played. They were fun things like SpongeBob SquarePants and Star Wars and some Olivia Rodrigo. But one of the pieces that we played, I used as a demonstration so they could understand here what the trumpet sound is and what the clarinet sound is. And we're gonna play that for you next.
Thank you.
back in February of 2013, the Apple Valley High School Wind Ensemble performed at the Minnesota Music Educators Convention that year. And the piece that we're going to play next was a piece that was relatively new around that time, and I picked the piece to play at the 2013 concert. If you're familiar with the Saturday Night Live skit, More Cowbell, that's what the piece is about. If you're not familiar with it, I encourage you to go on YouTube and Google it, because I think it's hysterical. But it actually has every single percussionist at some point is playing a cowbell through it, and the piece ends with seven people playing the cowbells. Now, there's a reason why you don't hear a lot of people playing this song, even though the concept is really cool. It is incredibly challenging, especially for our low reeds and low breaths. The tuba players are playing these 16th notes at quarter note equals 104. Tuba players never see music that is that challenging. And tubas, would you say this is like the hardest concert band piece you've ever played? Yeah, for sure. Now, the reason why I could choose this piece, though, is because we have three fantastic tuba players back there that are leading our team. And I knew this was the year that we can resurrect this piece and do this again. I believe the Van Boosters, no, I know the Van Boosters are having a bake sale out front, and you must buy every single item on that bake sale, because if you don't, Mr. Scalise and I have to eat the rest of the goodies for the next couple days, and neither one of us need any more food right now. We need more exercise, less food. So please buy everything. This last piece we're going to play is called More Cowbell from the suite called Pop.
Thank you.